Hey folks, Matt from MightOfTheImage.com. Got a question here from Julia on the email. Julia writes in, she says, "Hi Matt, I'm looking to buy my first camera for vlogging. My budget is around $1,000, so I'm looking to get the Canon EOS 77D. I've heard that the 70D is also a great camera at the same price, so I was confused between the two. The 77D has 60p video with electronic IS, better ISO range, and low light performance and lossless digital zoom. On the other hand, the 70D has better battery life, better body, etc. Which one would you recommend? Thanks." Well, thanks for your question, Julia. Interesting question because the two cameras are similar, but the 70D is an older camera and it doesn't have the newer 24 megapixel sensor in the 77D. It has a 20 megapixel sensor, which it's a little older and it's a little less megapixels. So in that sense, the 77D is a little better as far as a photo machine, because I think the new 24 megapixel sensor that's in the 77D, the 80D, and in most of the newer DSLRs now, it's probably the same one that's in the M50 really, is a very good sensor. And I would rather have that one than the 70D. The 77D is an interesting offering, and it's newer, and it does have some added features, as you mentioned, that the 70D does not have, including, as I mentioned, the resolution. The electronic IS, not really sure that's going to be of much benefit to most people. It's kind of electronic gimmicky thing. It's kind of an electronic gimmick. I'm going to have to test it some more. I didn't even really play with it when I had the SL2 in, but my initial thoughts on it are just, I mean, I really wasn't even interested in trying it because typically that type of thing just doesn't really work. It's, don't be confused here. It's not the same as having in-body image stabilization. It's some electronic manipulation. It's not true image stabilization. You're much better off just using the lens IS, is my opinion. Better ISO range and low light performance. I think that's true. I think, though, that the low light performance is probably going to be close. But you're probably right, the low light performance is maybe a tad better. The 60p, if that's an advantage to you, if that's something you would use, definitely. It's you know, another setting that you have. Lossless digital zoom, again, not a big fan myself, but if it's something you think you're going to use, again, it's a digital thing. It's not a true zoom. You're basically just cropping in camera. If you think that's something you're going to use and you think it's a feature, great. The better battery life, the better body, etc. Battery life can be an issue, but I mean, you can get a pair of aftermarket batteries like the Wasabi power batteries that I like to use very inexpensively. So I'm not really that concerned with the battery life. Actually, having just reviewed the SL2, which is actually a camera you might want to consider as well. We'll get to that in a moment. The batteries in there are even smaller than what's in the 77D and the 70D. The SL2 uses the same LPE17 battery that the Canon 77D does. That's the LP-E17. And I was actually really surprised. The SL2, the battery actually lasted quite a while. I was expecting it to be an issue, and it never was. I'm sure if I was doing a lot of video shooting, I might see it as more of an issue. But I did shoot quite a bit of video when I was out with it, and I actually never had to switch the battery. I got a pair of the Wasabi power batteries, and you can get that with a dual charger. And that was $22. So again, battery not so much an issue. Between the 77D and the 70D, I probably would go with the 77D because it's newer and it has that 24 megapixel sensor. It may even have, even though it's not necessarily explicitly stated, it may even have a little newer version of the dual pixel AF. I suspect it would. It's a newer camera, so maybe a little more tweaked version of it. The SL2, though, is something I think you might want to look at because with your budget being what it is there, $1,000 is going to get eaten up mostly by either the 7070 or the 70D, and you're probably looking at buying the kit lens. Whereas if you get the SL2, you could add, you could be at the SL2 with a kit lens, you could get the 50 f1.8, and you could probably get the 10-18 as well, probably all within that ballpark. Being a vlogger, the SL2 and the 10-18, so the kit lens and the 10-18 would probably be the best way to go, and then add the 50 f1.8 when you can, because the 10-18 is great for handheld vlogging. I mean, you'll see Casey Neistat and a lot of other vloggers using the 10-18 on a Canon APS-C body just to get that extra width, that ability to get everything in when you're only at arm's length with the camera. So the SL2, I think, offers most of what the 77D does at a much more competitive price. Plus, it's smaller and more lightweight. It has the fabulous dual pixel AF from Canon. It has the incredible 24 megapixel sensor. I was really blown away with it. I really enjoyed shooting with it in the time that I had it here, and I'm just working on getting my final review for it. But I would seriously look at that if I was you, because it allows you to spend a little bit more of your money on lenses, which I think will open up a world of possibility that you wouldn't get without, for instance, the 10-18. And I don't think you're really going to miss much between the SL2 and the 77D. That's what I would suggest. I think overall, I would suggest you looking very seriously at the SL2. And throw it back to our viewers. What do you guys think? Do you agree with me? Is the SL2 something she should be looking at? Do you think between the 70D and the 77D, she should go with the 77D? Or do you think the 70D still has merits, that maybe it's a little bit higher up the food chain as far as the build of the body and the and as we move towards a more professional level camera, that you would still go 70D? And then, like I said, out of all of them, what do you think? Me, I'm thinking the SL2 is the way to go. But what do you guys think? Let us know in the comments below. Love to hear your feedback. It's always great when you guys can help out our viewers, give them extra things to think about. Maybe it's something I've missed here that I haven't pointed out. Let's help out Julia. Thanks for your question, Julia, and stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at artoftheimage.com.